name's Abraham. This is Jay, that's Jesse. And our custom project was optimizing well song classification. So the client for this project was Imari. And our mentors were Daniel Klein, Carlos Rueda, and John McIntyre. A little bit of background about the project as a whole. So Imari is trying to understand complex humpback vocal culture. And they're trying to do this by analyzing the makeup of their songs and how they're shared among the population. Currently, this process is done by hand, which is extremely tedious and is prone to human error and bias. If you look at the image, you can get an idea of how this work is done. So a scientist looks at and listens to a waveform that represents the well song. Every time they run into a recognizable pattern, they log it into a file that represents the song as well. And just from that, you can kind of get a sense that this is going to take a while and the person can make a mistake or maybe not even catch something. So the motivations for our project in particular are to, one, accelerate the speed of song analysis, and to improve the consistency overall and eliminate human error. Just to give you a sense of what our objectives were before we go too into detail, they were to improve the pre-processing of song data before it's actually analyzed, and to visualize the patterns that are being generated by that application.
So, to better understand our contributions to the project, first, we must understand how we perform audio analysis. When we record sounds, we save them in the form of raw signal, which we refer to as amplitude. Unfortunately, though, amplitude is not adequate for visualizing information, or at least in the sense that we want. So, we apply a Fourier transformation to represent things in terms of frequency instead of amplitude. This figure is frequency plotted over time, and we refer to these types of graphs as spectrograms. Oftentimes, when we apply this transformation, the resulting spectrogram has lots of backscatter, additional background noise, and other pieces of information that make it noisy and hard to perform analysis of. So, this leads to our first primary objective of the project, to generate clearer spectrograms by introducing a new pre-processing method known as normalization. The normalization method we decided to implement is known as per-channel energy normalization, which I will refer to as PSEN. Now, PSEN's unique feature is that it provides automatic gain control, which automatically increases the gain whenever a unique whale sound is detected in the sound, in the song, and decreases the gain whenever ambient background noise is present. Here's the main takeaway. The top spectrogram was generated without PSEN. And after we implemented PSEN, this is what the resulting spectrograms look like. Notice the increased clarity of certain features along the top frequency. Now that we better understand spectrograms, we can talk about how an unsupervised machine learning algorithm takes these images and performs classification. An algorithm takes a spectrogram as an input and scans slowly across the entire image looking for consistent patterns. Every time a remarkable pattern is identified, it labels it one of these colors on this stacked bar plot. However, due to the nature of the unsupervised algorithm, we do not yet know what these colors indicate, only that some type of unique pattern is being repeated and a classifier is picked up on. This leads to our second primary objective: understand what these colors represent. To accomplish this, we developed a Python module which takes a small image every time the classification algorithm detects a pattern. Here is an example of one of those small images detecting a pattern. Now, to explain our results and their implications, here's Jesse.
For our result, we implemented a new normalization method called PSEN. However, PSEN has unexpected side effects due to the way it utilizes automatic gain control. Some frequency ranges show decreased noise, and other ranges show increase in noise levels. Since PSEN has changed the visual landscape of spectrogram, it caused the unsupervised machine learning algorithm to label the features differently. This figure was generated without PISA normalization. Utilizing the same song, this figure was generated using PISA. Notice how there's a significant difference between the colors and the consistency of labeling. We notice that in many of small figures being generated by our Python module, these figures were nearly indistinguishable from one another, even though they are completely different categorization. Moving forward, the label could be grouped differently in order to improve accuracy and precision. For example, categorizing both of ascending and descending mode as a general mode. As for pre-processing steps, many other methods can be tested for further optimization. Eventually, alternative unsupervised machine learning methods will be implemented in order to compare the label accuracy and processing times. Thank you.